Now you're really grasping at straws. After all, it was the victim, Doug Swallow, that was holding the medicine. I would like the court to recall the crime that happened here 8 months ago. Where did Miss Hawthorne hide the evidence? Huh? What are you talking about? 8 months ago, the poison was hidden in her bottle necklace, which she then gave to someone else for safekeeping. Someone she had accidentally run into in the reading room, my client, Mr. Phoenix Wright. Yes, that's right. She did say the same thing this time as well. After shoving the victim, Mr. Phoenix Wright left the scene of the crime. That's when the murderer, Dahlia Hawthorne, appeared. With her, she was carrying a poison bottle of Cold Killer X. This, of course, was so she could carry out her plan to murder Mr. Wright. I believe she did testify that she was going to meet with the defendant. Yes, and she heard and saw everything that happened at the scene of the crime. She knows that this guy ratted her out, including that the defendant and victim were arguing about the cut electric cable. When she realized, I can't allow him to live, zap, she used the severed electric cable to silence him forever. Unfortunately for her, this is when the problem occurred. Mr. Wright, who she thought had left the scene, came back to check on the victim. And on top of that, because of the power outage, some students were showing up as well. It's hardly any wonder that she was, as she put it, in a state of panic. Recall that she was carrying the bottle of poison cold medicine. She must have thought, what if they searched me like they did 8 months ago? 8 months ago? Yes, she disposed of the evidence exactly the same way as she did back then. She had someone else hold it, in this case, Doug Swallow. Oh, come on now, everyone. Surely you aren't fooled, are you? This stupid woman, she's nothing but a filthy, stinking liar. Right, Mr. Prosecutor? Huh? Yes, that's exactly right. Just pure desperation. I wonder which one of us is the desperate one here. Wow. So, Ms. Hawthorne, this cold medicine, I wonder if you wouldn't mind taking some? Well, Mr. Wright ate that necklace of yours, right? Now it's your turn to prove your innocence. What do you say? If I'm just a filthy, stinking liar, there's no need to worry. So come on, show us. I dare you to take some of the medicine right now.
Mia Fey! Mia Fey!
Oh, damn. Demon mode engaged.
Do you think you've won? Well, do you, Mia Fey?
That's just fine. For the time being, victory is yours. For the time being. Well, I have a very long memory, you know. Oh, you and I will meet again, I'm certain of it.
Oh, damn.
Well then, Mr. Judge, I'll see you later too, okay? Yes? I'm going to spend a little quality time with the men in blue now. I wish you all the best.
That wasn't ominous at all.
I will have my revenge.
Phew. It's finally all over. I refuse to accept this. The defense hasn't shown a scrap of evidence to support their outrageous claim. We just got an admission of guilt. Shut the F up. But even so, your witness seems to have accepted it. I don't care. I'm Winston Payne. And I don't believe one word that this rookie lawyer has said.
Well then, Mr. Payne, let me ask you this.
Yes?
Would you care to try this cold medicine?
What?
Just a little earlier, I could have sworn you said.
There, there. It's all right, rookie. For example,
I would trust the witness Miss Hawthorne with my very life. So, if she's so trustworthy, then I'm sure there couldn't possibly be any poison in here, right? Oh, well, you see, yes. And here comes the back pedal. Come on now, rookie killer. Show this rookie how it's done. How much trust do you have for this woman? Are you willing to bet your life?
Yeah. Oh, my hair is flying out my beautiful hair. No.
Oh my god. I told you this is how he goes bald. Called it. I was only joking earlier. Holy cow. We literally just scared the hair right off his head. Mr. Payne? About Miss Dahlia Hawthorne? Yes, Your Honor. I'll file papers for her immediate arrest. Tragic, but not surprising. Oh, shut up, Judge. He did, yeah, exactly. I knew there was something suspicious about her from the very beginning. Oh, piss off, Judge. Don't lie, just admit you were wrong. By the way, Ms. Fay. Yes, Your Honor. Was it just me, or did you and Ms. Dahlia Hawthorne seem to know each other? Your Honor? Whether we did or did not has no bearing on this case. Very well. Mr. Payne? This can't be happening. It's a nightmare. It's like losing to my daughter. It appears Mr. Payne has lost his spirit along with his hair. Does the defendant have anything further to say? It can't be true. My dear Dolly! Very well. I believe I'm ready to pass judgment and bring a trial to an end. Court finds the defendant, Phoenix Wright.
Damn, not guilty.
Ta-da! This court is adjourned.
Mia, you were wonderful in there.
Thank you for everything, Mr. Grossberg.
During the verdict, I thought my hemorrhoids were going to explode like Mount Vesuvius.
God, stop.
Mr. Grossberg, do you maybe think you could stop talking about them?
That's rather rude.
Anyway, this case really made me think.
I know, like what?
What does it really mean to have a relationship of mutual trust with the client? Perhaps it is we veteran lawyers who have lost sight of this. Oh, Mr. Wright, congratulations.
Thanks.
You know, I was thinking.
Go on.
The Dolly that I saw up there on the witness stand, I don't think that was really her.
What?
Yeah, the Dolly I know could never have said those kinds of terrible things. Maybe she was, like, I don't know, a fake or something.
Oh, this poor kid still hasn't got a clue.
You need to forget about her, Mr. Wright, for your own sake.
Yeah, you're right. It's probably for the best.
Also, you need to relax a little bit more, try to grow up a little.
But out of all my friends, everyone says I'm the most grown up.
Oh, what kind of company does this guy keep? Right now, I'm studying to become a lawyer myself.
That's what you keep saying.
But I thought you were in the art department.
Well, yeah, I am.
But there's a friend that I desperately want to help. And if I hurry, then I should still be able to save him in time.
I see.
Same as Faye. A lawyer is someone who can help people when they're in trouble, right?
Mr. Wright, I'm still new at this myself, but I think that's exactly what a lawyer is.
Okay, I'm going to do it. I'm going to study my butt off. I'll become a lawyer for sure.
I hope. I hope we see each other again someday.
Maybe even in court. Yeah, this is a prequel. 5 years ago, actually, according to that. Because Mia's dead.
like from the beginning of the first game, she's killed, and then she comes back as a spirit through the whole games. And yeah, this is back when Phoenix was originally on trial. I think that was mentioned in the second game that there was that Phoenix was up for a murder trial, like as a suspect when he was younger, and that Mia defended him. So now we get to actually see it. It's been 5 years since I was acquitted of all charges. I became a lawyer like I planned, and I managed to save my friend, but Mia has passed on to a better place. For me, this trial brings up a lot of painful memories, but it also brings up some very precious ones, and memories that I thought would never rise to the surface again. Mia is gone now, but even so, I can hear her in my mind. Phoenix, no matter what, always believe in your client. In a court of law, your greatest weapon is your belief. 5 long years, something has happened that's made me think back to her words of wisdom. But that is a story for another day. New episode has been added. Excellent. Well, guys, we're like an hour overdue for a break. Hi, guys. Welcome back. I was just trying to desperately swallow the last remnant of that wrap I was eating. Okay. Let's carry on, shall we? Yeah, let's save the progress. So what's everybody doing this morning? Anybody, or this afternoon, or this evening, or whatever time it is, wherever you are. Everybody up to anything good? Excuse me. Time is 1 a.m. Beep, beep. It's gonna blow! Oh. Okay, no explosion. Safe. Detective, we've made it. Phew. What a relief. Glad the jewel is still safe. Gumshoe! Oh, you said it, pal. It must have been our rock-solid security that scared them off. Would you mind opening the safe just to double-check? Flying in Elite Dangerous? Awesome! I have not played that game in ages. A cool game. They're adding all sorts of new stuff to it still, which is really good. Ah! We've been had! Mask the mask. Salutations. Out front, guards! Turn on the searchlights! Ha 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 ha! Better luck next time, gentlemen. Ah ha ha ha! Excuse me, but I'm afraid I must be leaving now. We shall meet again when the next moon is full. Ha 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 ha! Ah, ha, 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 ha. This guy loves his laugh, doesn't he? Hey, Nick, get a load of this. Hey, are you listening to me? You can clean the toilet later. This is important. What are you freaking out about now? Besides, hygiene is important, okay? Gotta maintain the facilities. Public health code, that kind of shit. You should be doing this, by the way, because that's what I employ you for, apparently. Or not, I don't know. You said you'd help around the office. Today will be the last time you talk to me in that way. Yeah. We're about to hit the big time. Big time. And what do you mean by we? You don't mean you and me are pregnant? No. Don't be silly. I'm talking about me. And Pearly, of course. Hello? It's my throat just went weird then. Excuse me. Okay. I'm good now. Hello, it's a pleasure to see you again, Mr. Nick. Oh, that was weird. Bells, you haven't changed a bit. Wait, what are you doing here anyway? Haven't you heard, Mr. Nick? Here, take a look at this. What is this, some kind of poster? Oh, it's the vase, the sacred urn. Kurian Village? That's right, that's our hometown, Perlium Mine, that is. What's this about treasures from the boonies? Haha, very funny. You can laugh all you want, but you'll be singing another tune tonight. Tonight? What about tonight? The treasures of Kurian. Or Kurain? 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 I think it's pronounced Kurain. I can't remember how I was pronouncing it last time. I'm going to say Kurain. The Treasures of Kurain exhibition doesn't actually start until next week, but the promoter sent us some special VIP entry passes. That's why I dressed up extra special today. What, wearing the same thing you always wear? Excellent. What do you think, Nick? Same Maya, different day. I mean, you literally are wearing the exact same freaking thing. This young lady here is Maya Faye. The younger sister of Mia Faye, my friend and mentor. I first met her 2 years ago. I was working on the case surrounding Mia's death, and ever since then, I've been the one who's been keeping this law office afloat from behind the scenes. Actually, that's just a cover for her true identity. In reality, she's a spirit medium and a bit of a shady character. Hey, who are you calling shady? And this little girl is Pearl Faye, but I usually call her Pearls. She's Maya's cousin and is a spirit medium in training herself. I know I'm a bit young, but I want to help in any way I can, Mr. Nick. Kurain Village is the home of the mysterious Kurain channeling technique. And Maya here is the daughter of Kurain School of Channeling's master. I know it sounds ridiculous, but it's no joke. I've seen her power with my own eyes. It's the real thing, alright. Earth to Nick, how long are you going to make two gorgeous women like us wait? Yes, Mr. Nick. I can't wait any longer. I want to see the exhibit. Looks like I don't got a choice here. Might as well head on out. So the fact that it's added this poster to the court record, so to speak. Yeah. We already know some shit's gonna go down. The Lordly Taylor Main Exhibit Hall. Lordly Taylor, the city's fanciest and most expensive department store. Treasure exhibit, huh? I have to admit, I'm pretty impressed. Why are they having it in a department store? Are they selling some of this junk? I mean, treasure? Wow, this is awesome! Yeah, you can make even the cheapest junk look great. It all depends on how you display it. Oh, they even have the dusty old hanging scroll that was in Faye's manor storeroom. Oh yeah, I remember the scribbling on it when I was a little girl. On a family heirloom? Say, Nick, the person in charge of this exhibit is waiting for us in the basement warehouse. Alright, let's go find the corpse. I mean, person. Guess we should go say hello. Let's examine everything first. The more dark chocolate today, 70% from Peru.
Nice.
I think I remember this old folding screen here. Does it have the hole in it still? I'm pretty sure it was an important piece of evidence in that murder case that happened in Kurain Village. This folding screen is the greatest of all spirit channeling secrets. The six-leaf Kurain sacred writing folding screen. Such a secret, why is it the most prominent thing in the exhibit? Sound like such a chocolate snob? Not at all. You can never be too snobby when it comes to chocolate. Especially dark chocolate. I had so Freya, you've heard of Hotel Chocolate Company, right? And they used to sell, maybe still do, a Vietnamese, what was it, 85% or 90% chocolate
I tried it once. Do yourself a favor and don't get it. It's horrible. It's like eating cigarettes. It's actually been mixed with tobacco leaves. It was horrible. Oh, it was disgusting. I didn't buy any more of that. It was literally like, you know, if you go into a smoker's house or something and you touch the furniture or something else, or your clothes after you've been in the room with them for a while, and you get that leftover residual scent. That's what the chocolate smelled like when you brought it up to your mouth, and I was literally like, ugh, ew. So, but I took the bar back to them. I'd eaten like maybe two or three pieces, and I was like, oh, this is disgusting. And I thought, do they have a satisfaction guarantee here? I took it back to them and said, look, I know I've eaten two pieces off of this. You can throw it away for all I care, or I'll throw it in a bin outside, but can I swap it for something else? This is gross. And they were like, oh yeah, we've had a lot of people coming back, they don't like it. Like, really? You thought cigarette-scented chocolate would be would be good for people? People would like that. Ew. You have a branch here. When it reopens, I'll hoard some better ones. They do have some nice stuff, don't get me wrong. You know, I haven't bought anything from them in a long time now, but I used to get their dark chocolate battens. So I do like those. I love 80% dark chocolate's gorgeous. A piece of cloth with a ton of finely written characters jammed onto it. Probably esoteric knowledge only mediums would know. Let's see. Here's the title English, in English. 108 ways to save money. That's right. I'm pretty sure the number has gone up since the last time I saw it. Well, we're always looking for new ways, you know. Being a medium sounds like a rough way of life. What's with this big cushion? It's just lying around with nothing on it. Must be for the greatest treasure of all. The greatest treasure? There's something like that. Huh? Why, of course there is. Right, Pearly? Oh, yeah, of course. Is it the urn? I'll bet it would really take your breath away. Or is that maybe what was in the safe we saw being plundered? I bet it is. I bet that's whatever was in the safe. Oh, Mystic Maya, look, I can't believe it. Ah, it's so cute, it's a little diorama of Karain Village. Yeah, look at that. Two whole buildings and a rock and a bus shelter. But somehow it seems to reek of dreariness. Oh, Mystic Maya, it's your house, it even says Fae Manor on it. Yikes, you're right. Kinda want to add the famous in front of it. Don't do it, Maya, they might get mad. Look at what trouble she is. They're just a bunch of old urns. Are these really treasures too? Of course they are. This is a treasure exhibit, isn't it? Well, yeah, I guess so. So all it takes to be a treasure is age. No wonder nobody likes museums. Yeah, but I'm getting better every day. Right, guys? Right. Of a battle royale. That note. Best of luck to all. Badum-tish. There's nothing else to click on then by the look of it. Nope. Alright. Let's move to the basement. Yep, this is a basement warehouse, all right. I have seen many in my time, and this one seems pretty bog standard. This place is scary. I feel like a monster could jump out at any time. Don't be scared, Pearly. I'll protect you. Oh, Mr. Wright! Eek! A monster! You were right! A monster? Adrian! Good evening. It's good to see you again. You? I know you. Nice to see you again too, little miss. She! She, the her, the thing, the woman, you, not Samus. Luigi, congratulations on winning the Battle Royale. Oof, good stuff. I'm gonna play some slots to celebrate. Cha-ching, big money, come on.
Give me that money.
Ah, hello. Is she a friend of yours, Nick? How do you know her, Pearly? Cha-ching! Look at that, I won. Boom. Nicely done. 20! Yeah, double the money. Double the fun. Nice to meet you too. I'm Adrian Andrews. I'm in charge of the promotion and planning for this treasure exhibit, so she got out of show business. Interesting. I'm also responsible for the security arrangements. You sucked, apparently. Ah. Oh, nice to meet you. Adrian sure has changed since we last met. So, this is the warehouse. The really valuable exhibit items are stored away in here. Cool. No clues here. Come on. Oh, security camera. It is trained on the warehouse door. It's set up to take a picture of anyone that enters or exits the door. This seems like a familiar system. She put up her hair up and gothified her clothes. Didn't she always have her hair up like this? I thought her hair was always up. No, actually it wasn't, was it? You're right, it was down to shoulder length. She was completely insane. No, she just had some issues. She was a bit creepy though. She was hyper dependent on people. That was the problem that we're having. An ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure, as they say. I mean, in the end, her whole thing was pretty tragic. This computer, it looks like it's hooked up to the security camera above. You know what though, because she was supposed to go to jail anyway at the end of the last case, wasn't she? Because she perjured herself pretty badly. So she had to go deal with the cops. She was going to go on trial. So she must have gotten off. They must have made, you know, an exemption for her. And that means what? The camera is set up to take a photo with anyone that goes in or out of the storeroom. You know, like the studio. Then the data from the camera gets uploaded to this computer here. That's what. I see. That's some pretty high-tech stuff. Yeah, we've seen it before. Brr. It looks like part of a signboard. All I can read on it is the burr. Ah, I've got it. Maybe it's supposed to say hamburger. Maybe, but you, lady, have a bit of a burger fixation. We need to talk about this. Why would anyone write hamburger that big? I don't know, maybe, you know, to advertise that they're selling them? Maybe for the World Hamburger Festival or something. I kind of doubt it, but I admire her commitment to hamburgers. Ah, I've got it. Maybe it said spaghetti. I don't think so. Why are you talking about food? Oh, wait, that's not. Anyway, it says burr. There's no way it could say spaghetti. Well, maybe it was a typo. A very big one. Like, as in every letter is wrong. It might have said spaghetti festival. What do you think? Okay to me, besides, spaghetti is the only thing more tangled than your reasoning. Ladder? Oh, look, a ladder. That's a step ladder. So, what's the difference? You need to stop judging things based on narrow-minded cultural assumptions, Nick. Yeah, Nick, don't be ladderist. Right, sorry. Why do I feel like I've had this exact conversation somewhere before? Like at every crime scene where there's a ladder? Mr. Nick, what's that big door over there? Looks like the door to the actual storeroom. I can see lots of big boxes and stuff back there. Really? Let's go in. I want to take a look. I'm sorry. Unauthorized personnel aren't allowed in there. Did you hear that, Nick? We're unauthorized personnel. Why are you telling me that? Like, seriously. Cool. Organic. This is where they keep the organic produce, kale. It says organi. No, it doesn't, Nick. It says organize. Can't you see the last two letters? Well, yeah, I guess no one else could read it either because this place is a mess. Yeah, you must feel right at home, huh? Yeah. Fine, judge a lot. Mystic Maya, take a look next to the door. That's Mystic Amy, right? Yes, that's a statue of the woman who invented the Karain channeling technique, Amy Faye. This is a statue on loan from one of the training halls of the Faye Branch family. In fact, it just arrived this morning. The Faye Branch family, that's Pearl's mom's family. What was her name? Morgan. Oh god, are we going to get to go back and deal with that? Because that never got dealt with. She was in jail and then she was all like, I will have my revenge on you all. Statue of the former Karain channeling technique is holding the big freaking sword. What's that creepy looking thing she's holding? Don't ask me, how should I know? Well, you are the future master, right? Maybe so, but this is the first time I've ever seen this statue. That thing is the Karain Shishkatato. Okay, it's a shish kebab. A shish kebabo. It's a ceremonial sword. Erikai! How's it going? We've returned to the Holy Phoenix. Yes. It's not a real weapon, so the blade isn't sharp. Oh, phooey, I wanted it to cut something. God damn, Maya, you need to just chill the F out. What are you eyeing me for, by the way? You planning to slice me up? So let's chit-chat. It really has been a long time, hasn't it, Mr. Wright? Nick, what's going on? Who is this woman? Why are you freaking out on me? Just chill. What? I just thought it'd be more dramatic if I got all worked up, that's all. Mystic Maya, you shouldn't let him get off the hook so easily. Please, Maya, don't say anything that'll needle Pearl further. Mr. Wright was there... Mr. Wright was there for me when I really needed help. It was something that happened 7 months ago. That's been a really long time. 7 months. It's pronounced Chi-Chi-Chito. Chi-Chi-Chito. Oh my goodness. Even then, that's still hard to say. You remember, don't you? The Nickel Samurai case? Not really. I was stuck in a dark wine cellar. Did that escape your memory, Nick? After that, I quit being a manager and started this job. Well, that's tough. I'm sorry, Ms. Andrews. It wasn't for us. No, don't say that. I'm glad the whole thing happened. Thanks to you and everyone else that was involved, I was able to change my whole life. I really am grateful. Whew, what a relief. And here we thought we destroyed a whole world. I'm really impressed, Ms. Andrews. Handling a huge exhibition like this must be very tiring. Well, Lordly Taylor is celebrating their 200th anniversary this year. Works on display in the main exhibition hall are worthy of the finest museums. Woohoo! Did you hear that, Pearly? The finest museums! Yes, I did. That's really wonderful. And they're doing it in a department store. I don't get this. Is this an American thing? The department stores in America have, like, art exhibitions in them, not like places where you go and buy art. You know, because I'm pretty sure they might have an art section where you can buy paintings and stuff. But do they have like a museum built into them where they show things off? Because I... Okay. This basement warehouse is pretty well protected, huh? Of course it is. After all, there are some priceless treasures in here. The security guards are all highly trained as well. That sounds good, so what's with the face she's making? Oh look, it's already 8. Have you all eaten yet? Well actually, I've already made a reservation at the restaurant on the 12th floor. Why don't we all dine together? Ooh, I like the sound of that. Dine. It sounds so fancy. All she heard was food. I'll have the kids' lunch. Pearly, it's dinner, not lunch. Why don't you go for it and really eat your fill with a kid's dinner? Okay, in that case, one kid's dinner for me. Shall we head upstairs then? We shall. After that pleasant evening, all that remained was to wait for the exhibition's opening. It was wonderful seeing Ms. Andrews looking so happy. None of us could have imagined that the very next day, something terrible would happen. Oh, please don't tell me she's found dead. Don't tell me she's the victim. Nick, this is terrible! What the... You're cleaning the toilet again? I never knew you were such a toilet freak.
Whoa, hey, don't make it sound weird.
Give me a break, would you? My brain just hit the snooze button for the fifth time. I'm going to turn on the TV.
We've got an update on the recent treasure heist. Based on clues found at the scene of the crime, authorities have announced... They believe it was the work of the renowned Phantom Thief, Mask the Mask.
The Mask of Masks?
No, no, it's what she always wanted, I think. Probably, yeah. According to a spokesperson, Lordly Taylor received a threat letter some days ago. This is the fifth heist by the Phantom Thief, who only targets rare treasures.
Lordly Taylor?
Well, Nick, what are you going to do?
Don't you dare go back to scrubbing the toilet.
Treasure? Lordly Taylor? You don't think...
Yes, now get up, Nick! It was stolen by Mask the Mask.
Our most valuable treasure.
The Karain's sacred urn was stolen!
What?
That cracked, broken piece of...
Yeah, the urn? That priceless spiritual treasure?
Yeah.
Refresh my memory a little. What is this sacred urn?
It was only the most important treasure in Karain Village, that's all, and it was the key to getting your aunt locked away.
Look, it's right there on this poster.
Yeah.
Don't you remember what's inside? The urn contains a very important soul.
Yes, Amy, Mystic Fae. That's why it says I am, because Pearls broke it and tried to put it back together again.
Which, the reason she was doing that was how we were able to debunk somebody's testimony.
Right.
Right, Pearly?
Ah, yes. That's right.
Hold up. I thought the urn had the name Amy written on it.
Oh god, Maya.
Now it says, I am. Any idea how that happened, Pearly?
there are some things best left unsolved, wouldn't you say, Mr. Nick?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because she was the one on trial for murder. So, yeah. Oh, that's right. 1 year ago, there was a murder at Karain Village, Maya's hometown. The sacred urn. It turned out to be an important clue in the case. What to do? Okay, the toilet is shinier than the judge's head. Let's see what's next.
What's wrong with you?
What do you mean?
What do you mean what? Mr. Nick?
Your beloved Mystic Maya's treasure has been stolen.
Okay, first, she's not my beloved anything.
More of a casual something. Second, I'm not a cop.
Doesn't that even bother you?
But I thought the urn was the village's treasure, so I don't see how...
The village is Mystic Maya. She's the future master of the Karain School of Channeling.
You know what I'm talking about, Mr. Nick. I won't let you say you don't.
Okay, okay, I do. So what am I supposed to do about it?
Isn't it obvious?
Go find the bad guy who did this.
Okay, I can give you Batman's number if you like.
You just need a flashlight,
a little toy bat, hang it in front of it and shine it into the sky.
Yeah,
and get the sacred urn back.
But I'm not a detective, I'm a lawyer.
That has nothing to do with this.
If you're a real gentleman, you would find out, find it for your beloved Mystic Maya.
Ah, there's no winning against Pearl's fairy tale image of love.
Oh god.
What do you call a disguised noodle?
I don't know, what do you call a disguised noodle?
So what's the name of this bad guy again?
Mask of the Mask.
An imposter! Slash ban, aka I am, I'm only joking. If anybody on this channel gets a pass to tell bad jokes, that's my wife.
I don't even get that. I can't tell bad jokes on my channel.
Oh, I've heard that one before, but I'd actually forgotten it.
Ah, it was terrible. I was arrested and everything.
Exactly, you are. Yes. 1 year ago, the murder in Karain village. A man was killed during one of Maya's spirit channelings. This urn wound up being a key piece of evidence that proved their innocence. Mr. Nick, would you mind not telling Mystic Maya about that? You promised, remember? You said you wouldn't tell anyone. I broke the urn.
Pearls, I didn't say. I wasn't even going to say that. I just said it was a piece of evidence. You just told Pearls.
Aww. Oh yeah, that's right. Now I remember this urn used to say Amy on it. And then she smashed it playing with the steel samurai ball. Pearls accidentally broke it into a million pieces. Literally a million, we counted them. She tried to secretly fix it. Let's just say it didn't work out so well. Sorry, I'm not good at arts and crafts, or spelling either. Have you heard the latest music from the band Plastic? They mostly rap. I see a monk sneaking in. Hey monk, how's it going? How was Monster Hunter? Anyways, this is how her gluing project turned out. She put the pieces together wrong, and now instead of Amy, it says, I am. I can't believe no one's noticed this until now, a whole year later. Can't believe it myself. Alright, so we don't tell her about the breaking of the vase. Whatever. Actually, let me have a look at some of these. Oh, we've still got the Magatama! Cool. Have a look what the text has to say. There's a giant building outside of the window. It's the Gatewater Hotel, a high-class luxury hotel. The chain is getting so rich they bought a whole chunk of the next town over. Started building a huge theme park. It's going to be called Gatewaterland. And to think that 2 years ago it was just a little hotel for businessmen. It gained notoriety after somebody saw, well, alleged to see the murder of Mia Fey in this very window. But they were involved. Charlie, a decorative plant. When she was alive, Mia really loved it. She even went so far as to make it our mascot. It must be nice to be a plant, just able to sit in the sun and photosynthesize. Hey, Nick, no time for daydreaming. That's right, Mr. Nick, no time for daydreaming. Until I find that urn, they're not going to give me a second of peace. So I'm going to check everything else in the room. An old movie poster. Apparently, this was the first movie that made Mia cry when she saw it a long time ago. Maya watched it recently and said she cried all night too, which I guess is why it's back up on the wall. I have to check it out one of these days. Done for the day, starting monologuing about food, very hungry now. Excellent. Well, you enjoy your dinner, mate. What's on the menu for today? What does the monk feast on today? Difficult-looking legal books standing a formidable row, they mock me. Actually, I've neglected them for so long, they're covered in a layer of dust. Ugh. Maybe I should actually try reading them once in a while? Just gonna throw whatever happens to be around together? That's sometimes the best kind of thing, is just like, I'll have a bit of this, a bit of this, a bit of this. Whoosh. No time for reading. Okay, apparently we can't read. What about the phone? Can I do that? It's my desk. I don't get to use it much, so the dust bunnies are starting to mount their assault. Or maybe if you spent less time just wiping out the toilet all day, Nick. Maybe I should wipe them out with a few well-placed swipes of my cleaning rag. Nick! You're making me upset. If you're worried about the cleaning, please leave it to me. At least Pearls is good at cleaning. Guess I better find the urn. Okay, yeah, that's everything. Can we talk about anything else? Nope. Move. Thank you for the host as well, dude. Much appreciated.
Always good to have you here, Monk. Right, let's see if we can find some clues that actually lead us to the bad guy. But it doesn't look like anything has been disturbed. Yep, looks pretty much the same as it did last night. Bad guy, huh? Hey, you can't poke around here, pal! Wait a minute, that voice. Oh no, not him again.
Gumshoe!
And Freya with the host, thank you! That's very much appreciated. It's you, and I'm the one who should be saying not again. Why is it that every time something bad happens, you always show up, pal? I should be asking you that. Aren't there any other detectives? No, I should be asking you that. What are you doing here and hanging around? Hey, I asked you first. Actually, no, he didn't. Why are you here anyway? All right, we got it. Why don't you two kiss and make up already?
Gumshoe!
Hello, it's been a long time, Mr. Scruffy Detective. Oh, it's you, little missy. Actually, my name is Gumshoe, Detective Dick Gumshoe. Now is a good chance for you to try to remember it, right? The real hero of the game. And if it's too long for you, you can just call him Dick. It's good to see you again, Dick, Mr. Detective Dick.
Oh god, yeah. Good to see you again too, I guess. Nothing else has changed, has it? I mean, we literally were told nothing has changed, but still.
Mr. Detective Dick, can you tell us about what happened?
Oh, you're trying to remember my name.
Atta girl. It's just Gumshoe, okay? Anyway, the thief stole something called the Sacred Urn. I know about that.
Oh? Well, the criminal's name was Mask de Mask.
I know about that too. Detective, can't you tell us something other than that?
Well, I guess I sorta kinda owe you guys in a way.
Yeah, we got you your job back, dude.
The crime occurred last night around 1:30 in the morning.
How exactly do you know that?
We got an emergency phone call from the guard at the scene of the crime, pal. He said the urn was just stolen.
Scene of the crime? You mean right here?
Wrong. The urn was being kept under careful guard in the basement warehouse.
The basement warehouse, huh?
So who was guarding the basement warehouse?
That guy. It's all his fault that the thief got away, pal.
He solves one case and gets a swelled head thinking that he's an ace detective.
Ace detective? Another ace? There's only room for one ace in this game.
Oh god. You know what? I so hope it's that Texas Ranger guy who's not really from Texas.
What was his name?
Oh, I forgot the name of the guy now. But I hope it's him. That'd be funny.
Hey, Detective Gumshoe, about this Mask de Mask. Is he famous?
What?
You're joking, right, Nick? Mask de Mask is the hottest thing since sliced bread.
Sometimes he appears as a museum guard. Sometimes he appears as a big brown bear, known to surprise unsuspecting victims. But underneath those disguises is the true Mask de Mask.
So he's some kind of master of disguise, huh?
And he only goes after the finest works of art, pal. Last night was his fifth heist. He stole a broken urn. If Lordly Taylor had only cooperated, I could have caught him this time.
What? And you knew he was planning on stealing the sacred urn?
Of course I did.
The guy always sends his calling card before he steals something.
Calling card, huh? They mentioned that on TV.
So why do you call him an ace detective anyway?
That's what he calls himself, pal.
I didn't make it up.
So what's he like?
Well, like I told you, Master Damask has made 5 heists so far. Fourth heist, Mr. Ace Detective managed to get the stolen treasure back.
Ow! That is impressive, and all by himself?
Yeah, I gotta admit it, pal. Maybe he really is as good as he says. Every time the thief sends one of his calling cards, we send one of our men on a stakeout. None of us has ever gotten so much as a glimpse of the guy.
But Mr. Ace Detective was able to retrieve the stolen treasure from the thief. Anyway, he's at the scene of the crime right now looking for clues. So he's down in the basement warehouse. I'm gonna call it right now. Ace Detective
is Mask the Mask.
He's using this as a means to propel him to stardom in the detective world. He commits the crime, then he solves it. Because he knows how it did it.
Oh shit.
I could be way off. So what is this calling card? Here it is. Don't show it to anyone. It's top secret, okay, pal? What's this mark on the front? That's Mask the Mask's signature emblem, pal. You could say it's his mark. All of his calling cards have got them on. They didn't mention that on the newsflash. We're withholding that detail from the public for operational reasons. The only way we can tell if it's a calling card is real or not is by this emblem. That actually makes a lot of sense. If you just, you know, give complete and utter, you know, super accurate details about this kind of stuff, anyone who commits a crime could make one of those and leave it to throw you off the trail. But that does make a lot of sense. That makes sense. When you get famous, there's always imitators. Mr. Nick, if you work a little harder, maybe you can have your own copycat someday. Thanks, I guess. So, can I present anything to him? To be honest, pal, there's something that bugs me. What's that? All the other items that were stolen by Master Mask were ones even I had heard of. They were all world-famous treasures. The Tear of Emanon, or the Crown of Bongora. The Sacred Urn of Karain. It's famous too, right, Pearly? Of course, everyone in Karain Village knows about it.
Everyone in the village knows about that sacred urn. A world-famous urn, that is.
Sounds like we've got an unpredictable thief on our hands. What about this? Sorry, pal. I didn't get much sleep last night and my brain's not really working right. Somehow I don't think sleep would fix the problem. Hey, keep it down. He might have a really good hearing for all you know, and might get mad if he heard. I can hear everything you are saying, pal. And he's mellow. To be honest, pal, there's something that bugs me. Blah, 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 blah. Okay. Let's talk about this. Remember, don't tell anyone about the emblem, okay, pal? Does the thief ever send these to the police? No, always to the victims. Up until now, the victims have always come to us looking for help, though. That's not what happened this time, you mean? You got that right, pal. Listen up. If you guys ever get one of these calling cards, I want you to come to us right away, got me? Yep, sure. They can steal my dusty lawyer books that I never get to read. Oh, that's Ms. Mia Faye. She was truly a beautiful person, pal. Huh? You knew her? You knew my sis? Sure, everybody in the police force knew her. We all lost a great friend that day. Mr. Scruffy Detective. I just got something in my eye. I'm not crying. You're crying. Shut up. Leave me alone. What about this person? Sorry, pal. I didn't get this. It's like, oh, Maya? Yeah, no, doesn't ring a bell. Yeah, literally, no clue. What about the kid? No? Okay, that's still all the same. Didn't get much sleep. Yeah, what about Adrian? Nothing to say about Adrian Andrews chilling out here? Okay. What about yourself? How have you been? He didn't get much sleep. He doesn't even know himself right now. A flashy thief who steals valuable works of art sends a calling card before the heists. I've been on this guy's tail ever since his first heist, pal. Yeah, you're doing a really great job, I can see. Yeah, because 5 treasures have been stolen since day one. He's doing fantastic. Oof.
Listen, pal, if you want to jump high, first you've got to crouch down, all right? I'm a little frustrated right now, but it'll make it that much sweeter when I catch him. Anyway, that's what I keep telling myself every day. Well, good luck, Mr. Detective. I believe in you. Oh, ain't you sweet? You're the only one that's ever said that. Only one? That's kind of sad when you think about it. Nobody's ever told him they believe in him. No! Oh. Alright, well, let's go to the basement. Oh, the sword thing. That's on the floor. The Shishachika thing, whatever it's called. No matter how many times we come here, this place always gives me chills. That's probably because it's air-conditioned to protect the art pieces, you know? Welcome to my private little banquet of chaos. Huh? What the heck does that mean? Holy shit, it's the penguin! Oh, this guy is totally a bad guy. Look at this guy! Wow! I'm afraid I have very little to offer, but please, make yourself at home. Pointy Nose McGee. who are you anyway? Shh, silence! Oh my god, did he just pull his eye out? Oh. Now I see, it's all becoming clear. What do you see? Barry! The truth, once again, has been eloquently revealed to me. That's a magnifying glass? Okay, I just thought it was like a telescopic eye. I didn't, I knew. Come on, I'm not that thick. Give me some credit. I mean, maybe, you know, I don't deserve that credit, but just this one time. A lawyer and a spirit medium. Neither very advanced at their trade. Wow. Did he just call us bad at our jobs? Am I wrong? I never lost a case. Shut up. Actually, I did. I lost the last one. Shit. Yikes, that's scary. How did you know that? How, you say? The universal skeptics would say that that is how. Nothing is a question of... what? The universal skeptics would say that how is nothing but a question of why. I am a traveler of both time and space and a swimmer of dreams. What is he talking about? I can't make heads or tails of it. Without further ado, let me fulfill what should be the first duty of any gentleman, which you have yet failed to do, and introduce myself. The name is Atme, Luke Atme. Okay. Ace Detective. Oh, hi. Let him intimidate you, Nick. Stand up and show him what you're made of. The name's Wright. Phoenix Wright. Ace Attorney. I'm Maya Fey. Ace Spirit Medium. Nothing of the sort. And I'm, Pearl Fey. I'm Mystic Maya's cousin and, Spirit Medium Ace Apprentice. Good job, Pearls. Excellent. Well then, shall we begin with our little game? Game? Why does the phrase one short of a baker's dozen come to mind with this guy? One short of a baker's dozen is still a full dozen, though, so that's maybe not too bad. Let's examine everything first. A box with paint on it. No. Tis, sir lawyer, please refrain from touching from such crude behaviour. Huh? What do you mean? This criminal is an artist, the crime scene is the canvas upon which he paints. Only I, Ace Detective Atme, have an eye with which is educated enough to read the signs. Can you translate that for me, Nick? I think he pretty much said don't touch anything, amateurs. If there's something you wish to know about, you have but to ask Atme. I know everything there is to know. I know everything there is to know about my rival, Mask Damask. What do I do now? Does he have any top secret information stuff that only a real crime buff would know? I'll think about what I've got to ask while I listen to what Mr. Ace Detective has to say. So it won't let us actually look at anything?
Interestingly though, the statue has been moved, the thing was broken. Whatever was in that box. Interesting. So, are you really as famous as you say? Because I've never heard of you. Oh, damn, that thing does come off. Of course, for a lawyer, you have a rather shocking lack of knowledge about the world. I have no idea anyone was left in the city that had not heard of me. Look at me. I am Master Mask's arch enemy, the Ace Detective Luke Atme. At this moment, there are two mighty figures which loom large over this grand city. One embodies the nefarious forces of darkness. The other, angelic cherubs of light. So which one are you? Exactly. Boy, now I'm really lost. What is he saying, Nick? I've been personally on the heels of this villain since his first crime. After learning the criminal's patterns, I thwarted his very latest loathsome larceny. I even returned the target of his tyranny, the portrait of Magina for the crime scene. And I did it all by myself. I took it back from Mask the Mask with my brawny mind and my brilliant muscles. Mapped it the other way around. Yeah, they mentioned it on the news that the Great People Around Town segment. They said that the museum gave you an incredible jewel as a reward. Well, compared to the treasure that I retrieved for them, it's not much. So in the end, the only thing that makes you great is your own self-praise. Gotcha. Ooh, tell us what you know about Master Mask and keep it simple, please. Like about how I have devoted my life to thwarting his dastardly deeds? Last night, here in the bowels of this store, we were locked in a most glorious battle. I see. Hang on a second. You were here last night? Here in Lordly Taylor? Naturally. Whenever Master Mask goes, you will find Atmel laying his elegant traps. Elegant traps? More like Master Mask out-eleganced you and made away with a beautiful getaway. By this time, I allowed him to escape with the illusion of victory. I wonder if I should ask him about what happened last night in more detail. Can you tell us exactly what happened here last night? But of course, after all, I always say that there should be no secrets between aces. Flattery will get you nowhere, Pinocchio. I first received the request for my services 20 days ago, and that was 10 days ago that we received Master Mask's calling card. You were hired before the calling card even arrived? Yes, you see, the person who hired me was quite rigorous and thorough. Adrian Andrews. A mere 10 days after hiring me, her worst premonitions were realized. A calling card arrived, right? Gotta yeet off now. No problem, Freya. See you later. Have a good day. Yes, so, ace detective that I am, I set the trap for the thief right in the warehouse. And I waited for him, alone. Alone, but why? Why didn't you go to the police for help? Ridiculous. Why would I seek help from such a singularly useless group of nincompoops? You've got a lot of nerve. After all, it was you that let Mask get away. I always operate alone and concealed out of sight of others. Corn-sealed? Yes, corn-sealed. See, what you do is you boil corn down into a thick gloop, almost like glue, and then you pour it over the thing you want to seal and let it set. I don't think that's really a thing. Precisely. Even the guards on duty here were unaware of my presence. To fool your enemies first, you must fool your friends. My own original proverb. Anyway, back to what happened last night. As I was saying, I hid here in the warehouse and waited for the thief to arrive. But I swear to you, not a solitary soul came through that entrance. Nevertheless, the sacred urn disappeared. But that's impossible. How could it just disappear? How, you ask?
Don't be ridiculous, Sir Lawyer. If I knew the answer to that question, I wouldn't be here. For someone who seriously messed up his own stakeout, he's rather full of himself. They're saying that even though Wong came through those doors last night, our precious urn still somehow vanished from under your nose? That's just not possible. Right, let's present the stuff. So here, I'm a lawyer. Look at my badge. I'm sorry, I can't be more helpful, but I have no interest to save that the finding of evidence against my arch rival. No, it's okay. Nick's just a bit of a piddling evidence hog. That's his defense style. Piddling evidence hog? You say in that case, I'd simply be wasting my breath. Yeah, I guess you're right. Thanks, Maya. Why couldn't you have said I was a rival and not a piddling evidence hog? Okay, so the Magatama doesn't do anything. Do not fear, young lady. I promise I shall retrieve your urn. Thank you, Detective Atme. I'm counting on you. Good, can we go home now, Maya? Final round between Detective Luke Atme and Mask the Mask is set to begin. Still, there's something funny about this guy. Yeah, but don't forget he managed to retrieve the treasure from the last heist. Yes, I even have a video of that details my role in the whole affair. I recorded it directly from the news on TV. Can I interest you in a copy? No thanks. So he's got nothing to say about the statue that is now moved. This is the same text. Master Mask calling card. It's got his emblem printed on it, right? Quite impressive. But I would expect nothing less from my arch-rival. I'm surprised to see you in possession of such a top-secret piece of information. Well, we've got an ace lawyer and an ace spirit medium and an ace cousin apprentice here. And we've got a not-so-ace detective that we usually, you know, bamboozle into giving us evidence. Yes, indeed, I think I could learn to like you, my fellow ace professional. I don't know if I really want this guy to like us, ever. Well, Sir Lawyer? I've been told that you two are pursuing the mysterious thief. Well, I'm not sure I would say that. That's right! We're going to find the sacred urn no matter what we have to do. Excellent. I'll trust you. I permit you to look around while I investigate elsewhere. If perchance you should discover something of value, return then to my office. My Office of Earthly Delights, the Atme Detective Agency. Office of Earthly Delights? It makes it sound like a brothel. Well then, Sir Lawyer, if you'll excuse me, I have much to do. Poof, he's gone. Puff of smoke. Wait a minute. He's gone. I don't like the idea of doing this guy's work for him. Come on, Nick. Don't worry about it. It's no big deal. Let's hurry up and investigate before he changes his mind. I want to go to his office too. Take me with you, okay? Alright, finally we can look around at shit. So the camera was pointing to the door. A security camera. Go stand in front of that door and it'll snap your photo too, Pearly. Mystic Maya! Do you think I should smile? Nah, it's for criminals, so I don't think you should make a really scary I think you should make a really scary face. Like this. Ugh. Hey Pearly, do you know what this is? It's a computer. A computer? Oh, I've heard of those. It has such a cute name. It looks like the computer is storing data from the security camera. When someone comes in or out of the warehouse, the camera takes a photo. It's probably the trap the detective set up. I mean, it's pretty frigging obvious as a trap goes. Let's see if we can find the night's data on this thing. We might even find the photo of Master the Mask. Let me see here. Man, I really stink at working these things. What's wrong, Mr. Nick? You're sweating an awful lot. I don't know how to pull up the photos. I had no idea you were so pathetic with high-tech stuff, Nick. Yeah, well, I managed to print out the camera data anyway. I guess you have to learn to crawl before you can walk, right? Yeah, sure. Anyway, looks like the camera caught on only went off once last night. Around 1 a.m. on the night of the crime. But it doesn't actually show the picture. So that box had the urn in it. That pathetic looking wooden box. Ah! That's the box that had the sacred urn in it. Don't touch it, there may be clues to the thief's identity on there. Ugh, I worked so hard to make that box. Huh? You made that poor excuse for a box? I think it looks a decent box. Get off her back, Nick. What's that supposed to mean? The urn has always been on its stand in the winding way at Fey Manor, so there was no box suitable for it, Mr. Nick. And I was so proud of it. Poor Maya. Maybe it had been better if Master Mask had taken the box too, and then nobody could see what a hideous box it is. Wow, this is awesome. What did Ms. Andrews say this was called again? The Shichi... Shito. Chichi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-ch
a seven-branch sword in Japanese, or so says Miss Andrews. Well, it's pretty heavy. One hit seven times the fun. Pretty catchy, huh? I better to sell like hotcakes. There's something about that that bothers me. Wow, you're really firing on all cylinders today, Pearly. The sword. Wasn't Mystic Amy holding it last night?
Yes.
And another thing, the sword wasn't bent last night like it is now. You're right. Awesome, Pearly. I wouldn't expect any less from my little ace apprentice. The sword is bent, so that must mean last night someone used it somehow. Ah, I just thought of something. Maybe Detective Atme smashed the mask with it. Like this. Ugh. Ow! What the heck? What do you think, Pearly? I think it's even more bent than it was before. Oh man, my head. Ow, my hair. So the Cheetah Cheeto has been added. Wasn't bent before the crime. Interesting. This statue of Mystic Amy is so cool. I want a gold statue of myself. We could put it in the office. Hey, it's Wright & Co. How about a gold statue of me? Mr. Nick, I'm sorry, but I noticed something strange. Huh? What is it, Pearls? See, Pearls is literally doing the job we're supposed to be doing. The statue of Mystic Amy? Was this where it was last night? Ah! I'm pretty sure it was closer to the door. Yeah, I think you're right. Great job, Pearly. I wouldn't expect anything from an ace cousin. The statue was moved on the night of the crime. And then we've got paint here. Look what you did, Nick. You spilled paint over here. I didn't do that shit. Well, it wasn't here last night. I would have noticed the colour is out... a colour this outrageous. And you're basically wearing it, first of all. Second of all, you've been with me this whole time. When did you see me pick up some paint and spill it? Hmm? This paint has already dried up. Well then, you should have cleaned it up before it dried, Nick. Paint doesn't dry that fast. Besides, I told you it wasn't me. Looks like it's been several days since it was spilled. Really? Interesting. So that paint was there behind the statue, we just didn't see it. Hey, look at this. What is it? There's some kind of shape left in the bottom of the side of the stain. Huh? You're right. Wonder what it could be. Well, obviously it's a shape of the box. Mr. Nick, what's that big door over there?
Looks like it's the door to the actual storeroom. I can see lots of boxes and big stuff back there. I guess that's where they were keeping the sacred urn. Remember, Maya? Ms. Andrews said we're not allowed in there. So let's go in. Think we've got anything else to click on? If that paint's been dried several days, it had to be there, which means this box had to be there when they splashed it with paint. But then the box was supposedly in the safe, right? So that could have happened days before, and then it could have been put in the safe afterwards, and then the statue could have just been rolled over the paint stain to cover it. Hey Nick, your cell phone's ringing. Beep. Hello, Phoenix Wright here.
Oh, it's me, Gumshoe.
Oh, is that your new opening line now, Gumshoe? Can we change that? Gumshoe, what is it? What's so funny?
I'll tell you what's funny, pal. I finally beat him. I beat Mr. Ace Detective. You shouldn't hit people.
Finally, this underdog is the alpha dog today. That stuck-up detective's met his match.
Yep. Finally caught him, lock, stock, and barrel. There's no escape for him.
You caught him? Are you saying...
You captured Mask de Mask?
Bingo! Well, actually, he's surrendered. But I still got him.
Mask de Mask surrendered?
That's great. So when can we come up and pick up the sacred urn?
Well, you see, I was gonna tell you.
What? Something wrong?
Do you think you can swing by the detention center sometime?
Detention center? He wants to talk to you, Mask the Mask, that is.
What? He wants to talk to Nick?
I'll be waiting for you, pal. Get over here soon.
Beep!
Detention center, huh? We've also got the detective agency to go to as well. What happens if I go here? I'm gonna go here first. Then we'll talk to Atme. Alright. Oh, hey pal, welcome to the detention center.
You're sure in a happy mood?
Yep, after all, we got masked the man. Right, but, so where's the sacred urn?
Oh, sorry about that, pal.
Guess I didn't really think about it before, but you're the victim in this case.
Hmm?
Well, I guess I should let you guys hear the story straight from the horse's mouth.